Hello kids, hope you are all fine. This is your unit 6, the Tarnetar Fair. Have you visited a fair? Yes, surely you must have visited one of the fairs in Gujarat or maybe of the other states. What is a fair? A fair is actually a large event where people do business, sell, show various things and their goods. Again, fair is a noun actually. Fair has a one meaning, that is a type of entertainment in a field or park is also called as a fair. We will go to the activity one now. What is activity one? That is about recalling your experience that you had in a cultural event. You may have seen various cultural event of your schools. How that are? That were, was it in drama, in an auditorium, a musical night or a folk dance event, something else? What is a folk dance? A folk dance is a dance of a particular group of people, can be said as from one state like Gujarat. Gujarat folk dance is very famous, that is Garba, now which is upcoming festival of the month of October. The second is, you can say that all the states of our country has variety of folk dances. So that can be an event of your school. What impressed you the most or what did you enjoy the most at that event? Then what you enjoyed most in your event of school drama or your musical night? What is most loved one part of your cultural programs that you have to discuss? Share your experience with your partner. A few students could come in front of the class and narrate their experiences. Avoid a repetition. Means once the person is telling that I loved the dance of senior KG, it was very nice, giving us a nice moral value of cleaning our cleaning habits of our teeth and all that. Basically in pre-primary we have such type of dances. Then it can be depending upon your age and your criteria that variety of dances were performed in your school program, maybe annual function or a cultural event. So that you can discuss. But what you have to do, don't do the repetition. If someone is telling senior KG's dance I liked most, then you don't talk on that. Though you liked, you can again review the another one, whichever you remember. So this is the rule for it. Now coming to the activity two, which is our lesson. The lesson is about a fair which is in Gujarat, and this is the symbol at the right which is showing the Gujarat tourism. The lion. Why the lion is there? Because the lion is famous animal of Gujarat, because we have that Gujarat's wildlife sanctuary reserve for lions, right? India has a rich cultural heritage. Every state has its uniqueness in practically all aspects of life. Means whatever, our India is having a rich cultural heritage. It is very famous for variety of food, clothes, art and crafts, entertainments, philosophy, mannerisms and a very way of living. Whatever living standards, the clothes, the styling, that is different. As you can say that when you will go to Telangana, you will listen the Telugu language with their cultural or the folk dance, right? Their language will be different. In South, you will enjoy the idli, uttapam and rasam, all these recipes. So that is the variety of food. If you will come to the Gujarat, you will surely enjoy the garba. You will enjoy the dhokla, handwa and all delicacies over here. You may get the entertainments related to the state. So this is the way. Mannerisms mean there are variety of mannerisms of talking and speaking. Here people will ask you kem cho. That is really a nice question about asking someone instead of asking namaste and all that. Before that they will say Jai Shri Krishna and kem cho. So these are the words that are showing the mannerisms and the way of living. What is the way of living? That can be different. Okay. With your clothing, with your living style, with your houses, the patterns on your walls and all that is included. Variety of things are included in the way of living. Gujarat too is proud of its culture. It has a vast variety of dances with its accompanying music and colorful costumes. Really, when we read the word Gujarat, it gives an energy like the Garba. It has a very much energetic dance form, which is including variety of colorful costumes and music. The natives of each village or town have special occasions when they burst into their dancing revelry. What it is, revelry here means merrymaking. This time I have written the words over here, so it will be identical for you and it will help you to learn, understand the meaning while reading or listening. If you think you are prepared to walk out of your mundane means dull or ordinary experience and free fall into a real variety of colors, romance and music, then head for the Tarnetar Fair. Head means come there to the Tarnetar Fair. If you are feeling boring, dull or ordinary life and you want to enjoy that merrymaking, then you would have to visit. Head means to visit, to come forward for the Tarnetar Fair. For further information, you can visit to this website www.gujarattourism.com. Why? Because this is held in Gujarat. So this is your activity 3 now, based on listen to the story as your teacher reads it, then you read it silently. So this is our main story, and the story is about the real Tarnetar Fair, based on the legend. Legend means an old story about a person or an event. Okay. Draupadi Swayamvara. This is related to Mahabharata, right? This fair is celebration of ethnic Gujarat's folk dance, music, costumes and arts center. So this Tarnetar Fair is, this fair is a celebration of ethnic Gujarat's folk dance, music, costumes and arts centered around young tribal men and women seeking marriage partners. So what do you mean by ethnic? Ethnic means national or racial group of people. Okay. So this is the purpose of the fair. What is the purpose? To find out the life partner for the marriage. But even for those not interested, means those who don't want to get married or those who are already married, they also enjoy this fair. Why? But even those not interested in finding a spouse, the romance and excitement in the air is captivating, means holding your minds, the enjoyment, what is going on there. The Garba dance, its musical beats and everything is really enjoyable for every person around there. And every year, the fair seems only to grow in popularity, attracting visitors and tourists from Gujarat, elsewhere in India and even abroad. Means people love the Tarnetar Fair, those who are from various states, from India and from abroad. Even out of India, people also come here and enjoy this Tarnetar Fair. Here are the many colored costumes. Okay. Many color costumes are the facility of Tarnetar Fair, that are glittering ornaments and free spirited moments of folk dance. Dances as all combined to create a memorable scene. We every year see that the Garba is a form where it is basically performed in a circular motion or with the small circles. In large garbas, you may have seen variety of groups of people. They are dancing together on single floor. So this is the main purpose, that together it is an enjoyment. And that is why it is called as world's longest dance festival. Correct, children? So this is the speciality of our Gujarat's Garba, and that is very nicely explained over here. As the dancers surge in waves of cultural moments, the incessant means constant, continue dance chalta hai. Thrombing means beating. The drums keeps them moving in unison. Unison means together at the same line. They are enjoying everything in a same line. एंड द ड्रम बीट्स कंटिन्यू थ्रू आउट द डे. जो भी घंटा, एक घंटा, दो घंटा, वॉट एवर द आवर मे बी, वन और टू और थ्री, दे आर एंजॉइंग दैट डांस कंटिन्यूअसली ऑन दैट सेम फ्लोर विद द फ्रेंड्स, रिलेटिव्स और द सोसाइटी मेट्स. द डे इवन एज द डांसर चेंज फ्रॉम वन ग्रुप टू द अनदर. दिस इज डे टाइम, इट इज टेलिंग अबाउट द तरनेतर फेयर. सो दे आर कंटिन्यूअसली एंजॉइंग इन ग्रुप्स, दे आर चेंजिंग द ग्रुप्स एंड दे आर कंटिन्यूअसली डांसिंग विथ ईच अदर्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ अवर तरनेतर फेयर, ऑल्सो सिमिलर टू द गरबा डांस. देन नाउ वट एल्स इज देयर रिटन, दैट मेनी काइंड्स ऑफ फोक डांसेस आर परफॉर्म्ड बाय फार द मोस्ट पॉपुलर द रास. मोस्ट पॉपुलर उसमें फॉर्म जो होता है डांस का, दैट इज रास. ओके, एंड वॉट इज द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ द रास डांस, इन विच डांसर्स होल्ड स्टिक्स टू क्लैक. क्लैक मीन्स शार्प नॉइज होता है, वो एक दूसरे के वो स्टिक्स पे जो मारते हैं, दैट इज शॉर्ट और नॉइज, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज क्लैक. अगेंस्ट दोज ऑफ अदर डांसर्स, एज मेनी एज 1-200 वुमेन परफॉर्म रास डांस इन अ सिंगल सर्कल. एक ही सर्कल में कई सारे, मतलब पेयर में लोग आकर ये डांस करते हैं, टू द बीट्स ऑफ फोर ड्रम्स एट द टाइम ऑफ ट्यून्स ऑफ जोड़िया पावास मीन्स डबल फ्लूट्स. You may also see people break out into a spontaneous hudo happening naturally. Hudo होता है एक डांस फॉर्म, उसमें क्या नीचे बैठकर ऊपर उठकर ऐसे जोर जोर से डांस को एंजॉय किया जाता है आवाजें कर कर, राइट. सो दिस इज द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ वेरियस गरबा राउंड्स एंड दैट आर परफॉर्म्ड इन दिस तरनेतर फेयर. रबारी वुमेन ऑफ नियर बाय झालावाड़ी परफॉर्म. दिस इज द ट्राइब मीन्स कास्ट, यू कैन से दैट. ओके, वुमेन ऑफ नियर बाय झालावाड़ी परफॉर्म. झालावाड़ी मीन्स द देयर रीजनल एरियाज, और यू कैन से दैट वट एवर दे कॉल्ड विथ अ टिपिकल गुजराती नेम्स, दैट इज दे परफॉर्म द फेमस सर्क्यूलर फोक डांस रहाड़ो. वो क्या डांस करते हैं? रहाड़ो. Their marital status is indicated by their costumes. A black jimmy means skirt means she is married. जो लोग black jimmy पहन के आए हैं वो married है. But if a woman is wearing a red jimmy, it means she has not yet tied the knot. Probably seeking a husband means यहाँ पे वो husband ढूंढने के लिए आई हो. So that shows the identical things. Because you cannot understand, you are not getting any sort of card over there. And there is not mic or an anchor who is going to introduce you. That is a big question, right, kids? So this is the way with the colors you can identify them. The potential husbands seeking brides are elegantly dressed in colorful dhotis. What the boys are wearing now? They are wearing the colorful dhotis, artistically designed waistcoats. Waistcoats means the jackets, sleeveless jackets. And head cloth twisted in an angle. ऊपर जो होते हैं वो that is called as your head gear, right? And that is your head cloth twisted in an angle, moving about the fair ground at Tarnetar with striking umbrellas. How the umbrellas are there? That are striking means making rounds, advertising the bachelorhood they are keen to relinquish. This is the purpose, that they will show their umbrellas that they are the bachelors. Okay, so this is the speciality of identifying them. Then what is the another thing? Numerous sadhus and bhajan mandalis, religious music groups are engrossed in singing continuously. Matlab sadhu ye log bhi wahan par hote, bhajans mandalis, they are singing various religious music groups. Okay, accompanied by folk instruments, they will be accompanied with the variety of folk instruments like bansuri, dhol and whatever is a folk instrument of that folk cultural program. The Tarnetar Mela covers a large part of the Tarnetar group. I'm on page 53 and paragraph 5. What is the speciality about Tarnetar fair? The Tarnetar Mela covers a large part of the Tarnetar village. Why the name is given? That is depicted over here. Because it is held in the Tarnetar village and that is huge number of stalls put up to sell beautiful local handicrafts. We also know that the local handicraft is very famous of Gujarat and that is unavailable elsewhere. मतलब ऐसा handicraft वहाँ पे रखा जाता है जो कहीं पे नहीं मिलेगा. जैसे मल्टीकलर की वो चिड़िया होती है, हाथी के शेप होते हैं, उसमें कुछ कपड़े की बनी हुई दीवारों पे टंगाने के तोरण, अलग अलग चीजें हमें हैंडीक्राफ्ट में गुजरात में बहुत ही ब्यूटीफुली डेकोरेटेड मिल जाती है. सो दैट इज रियली अनअवेलेबल एल्सवेयर इन इंडिया अलॉन्ग विथ एथनिक ज्वेलरी. और ज्वेलरी होती है जो कई बार सिल्वर मेटल की होती है कई बार, और वो दिखने में व्हाइट होती है, ब्लैक ऑक्सीडाइज होती है. दैट वेराइटी ऑफ ज्वेलरी इज फेमस ओवर हियर. स्टैचूज ऑफ डेटीज एंड ट्रेडिशनल अटायर विथ टाइनी मिरर्स एम्ब्रॉयडरीड इन टू द क्लॉथिंग. दिस इज द स्पेशलिटी ऑफ ट्रेडिशनल अटायर. अटायर मीन्स क्लोथ्स विच आर फेमस इन गुजरात. दैट आर स्पेशलिटी ऑफ द गुजरात क्लोथ्स. दैट टाइनी मिरर्स, छोटे छोटे गोल सर्कल ऐसे मिरर होते हैं, वो मिरर होते हैं स्टक इन वेराइटी ऑफ कलर्स ऑफ थ्रेड वर्क एम्ब्रॉयडरीड वेरी ब्यूटिफुली ऑन द ड्रेसेस. देर आर ऑल्सो मेरी गो राउंड राइड्स. यू कैन सी इन द फोटोग्राफ दैट मेरी गो राइड्स एंड द पीपल अराउंड इट. ओके, दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड मेरी गो राउंड. देर आर ऑल्सो मेरी गो राउंड राइड्स, फोटोग्राफर स्टॉल्स, मैजिक शोज एंड टैटू आर्टिस्ट who attract a large variety of visitors. I think if you have visited any of the village fair, then you must have noticed that the village fair is incomplete without these attractions. Means those who are getting or interested in getting married, they will play there. But what about the others? The family member will come over there. They will enjoy the variety of stalls, the playing amusement park and all that. So that is the purpose of the fair and that is why it is called as the fair. Correct? Let's read the sixth paragraph with the explanation. The fair is held for 3 days every year during the Hindu calendar. Dates of Bhadarva, Sud, 4th, 5th and 6th during the Georgian calendar months August and September. These are the dates which are confirmed and decided for this Tarnetar fair. So every year according to the English calendar and according to the Hindi calendar, the dates are given here over here for visiting the place. The Tarnetar fair is held 8 km from the town of Thangad. Where is the location now? That is described in the 7th paragraph. So this place is 8 km from the town Thangad. The town is in Surendranagar district. This is the nearest railway station and that is the railway station place Surendranagar on the Ahmedabad-Happa broad gauge line. The nearest town with road transportation to other places is Chotila. So if you want to come by bus, then you have to come the nearest town, that is Chotila, and the distance between Chotila and Thangad is 25 km from Thangad. Okay, transportation to other place is Chotila, that is 25 kilometers from Thangad, which is connected by ST buses from Rajkot 75 kilometers, Jamnagar 162 kilometers, Ahmedabad 196 kilometers, or Porbandar 252 kilometers. From Bhavnagar, Chotila can be reached either via Rajkot. Okay, a trip of 264 kilometers or via Botad. This is the place name. A shorter journey of 190 km means a shorter journey will be from the Botad. That is 190 km. Chotila, Thangad and Tarnetar are well connected by ST buses and other modes of transportation. Like by roadways, if you want to go, then you can go to Thangad by this variety of transports in given distance kilometers. The nearest airport, if you want to go by air, then airport will be in Rajkot, that is 75 kilometers away. The coolies, now in 8 paragraph, detailed information about the umbrellas is given, which the bachelor boys of the Tarnetar fair are holding. The coolies of Saurashtra initiated the custom of embroidering umbrellas, means they have started embroidering those umbrellas of Tarnetar fair, which are exquisitely, means very beautifully, extremely beautiful, carefully made, elaborate in terms of embellishment, means very nicely that are decorated. The embroidery of each is unique. And what is the speciality of that umbrella decoration or the embroidery? That are made always unique, means a single person's embroidery is different from the another one and rises from the edges all the way to the top. It will start, means it rises from the edges with headwork, with beadwork and patchwork. The speciality of the work is beadwork, means the golden silver ball, colorful balls you must have seen. Usi ko kaha jata hai the beadwork. And the patchwork means colorful patches of different colors are attached with the main basic piece of cloth, and that is embroidered together very beautifully is the design as well. Small colorful handkerchief, and at the corners of that umbrellas you could find out that handkerchiefs are hanging, are attached all around the edge. When the person will swirl the umbrella, it will look very beautiful. That is the purpose of those umbrellas. Umbrellas decoration. Then what is to attract further attention? So that will be an attraction for the brides to look at the grooms. These men spent over a year embroidering their umbrellas, and actually this is handwork, very fine work is done, and that is the reason it took around a year to complete the work. Their intention is to entice the girls with their art, clothes and headgear and impress them, means that is the purpose, okay, to attract the girls with the art, clothes and headgear and impress them so that they can propose them for marriage. Or wahi reason hota hai ki because of that only they can, the girls can propose them for the marriage. It is not surprising that before the fair is over, they usually meet the lady of their choice. And because of this beautiful decorated umbrellas of the coolies of that Saurashtra, the bride meets to their grooms, and that is the reason that usually they meet to the lady of their choice. Isn't it an interesting and surprising lesson, children? Because this is really surprising fact, and you can say that this is a fact which is we are unknown about, though we are staying in the same state. So hope you enjoyed the lesson. This is very nice story to read again. Read it again and try to understand the culture of our country, India, and of our state. So let's explore it in more detail.